Welcome for grade to the online class. Hi, I'm teacher Sara Alcaraz. Let's go into your daily routine. Ready? Today is Thursday, May 28, 2020. How is the weather today? It is partly cloudy, windy, cloudy, rainy, sunny, snowy, or stormy. What you can tell me about temperature? It's burning hot, hot, warm, cool, cold, or freezing cold. Tell me about you. How do you feel today? Are you happy, sad, angry, bored, fear, worried? Are you sick? In the town, unit 5. Pay attention to this video.
There is, they are. Now, we will learn the use of words is and are with the word there. There is one cake. There are 10 balloons. There is one clown. There are 7 children. What do you observe? We use the words there is with one person or object. We use the words there are with more than one person or object.
There is, para una sola persona o objeto. There are, para más de dos personas u objetos. Let's open our book on page 55, ¿ok? Vamos a abrir nuestro libro en la página 55. And let's listen and say. Vamos a escuchar y a repetir. Ready?
There is a library. There isn't a library. Is there a library? Yes, there is. No, there isn't.
There are 2 restaurants. There aren't 2 restaurants. Are there 2 restaurants? Yes, there are. No, there aren't.
Okay, aquí tenemos las estructuras para decir ahí hay o en negativo. Cómo lo convertimos en pregunta y cómo respondemos positivo o negativo. Si te das cuenta, solo en la pregunta cambian de lugar. ¿Ya viste? There is there. In negative only, we change the verb here. En negativo solo cambiamos nuestro verbo. Y le ponemos la contracción and o not y ambas son correctas. Podemos escribir isn't o is not y ambas son correctas. Al igual lo tenemos aquí en plural, ¿de acuerdo? Es la misma estructura, excepto que cambia el verbo to be. Listen and play the guessing game. Let's pay attention. Vamos a escucharlo.
Is there a library? Yes, there is. Is there a clothing store? No, there isn't. It's town B. Well done. Now it's your turn.
Aquí vamos a jugar adivina quién, ¿de acuerdo? Pero con lugares. Entonces pueden hacerlo en casa con alguien que esté ahí dispuesto a apoyarnos y van a hacerle preguntas. Por decir, en tu mente eliges la parte de y le haces preguntas, ¿no? ¿Qué hay ahí con las estructuras en inglés? Es todo lo que vamos a hacer aquí. Let's go to page 113. Now, here. Answer. Use yes, there is, or no, there is. ¿Ok? Vamos a responder solo yes, there is, or no, there is. Depende de qué nos están preguntando. Number one. Is there a bakery? Yes, there is. Two. Is there a library?
No, there isn't.
Number three. Is there a pet store? Yes, there is. Is there a supermarket? Yes, there is. Is there a restaurant? No, there isn't. Six. Is there a toy store? Yes, there is. Observando nos damos cuenta si hay o no hay lo que nos están preguntando. Look and complete and guess the town A or B. Let's make. Vamos a hacer preguntas. Observa, si dice A, solo se refiere a uno. Y si dice two, se refiere a dos. Entonces vamos a cambiar a are there. Is there, are there, are there. Aquí nos dice cómo vamos a responder. Yes, there is, there are, porque aquí utilizamos are, ¿te acuerdas? Yes, there are. Yes, there is. No, there isn't. And yes, there is, okay? Now, it is a picture A or picture B? Picture A. Very good. It is a picture A. So, let's review. Vamos a repetir las respuestas para cerciorarnos que sean correctas. Yes, there is. Yes, there are. Number three, yes, there is. Number four, no, there aren't. Yes, there are. Yo aquí no las tengo escritas, pero como tú ya las vas a tener escritas, va a ser más fácil responder en positivo o en negativo. En dado caso que requieras apoyo, puedes regresar a la página 55 y tomar de ahí los ejemplos. ¿Ok? Now, let's go to page 102. Vamos a la página 113. Here. Aquí tenemos las estructuras, como ya lo habíamos visto en la primera parte. Forma positiva, negativa, interrogativo, pregunta, respuesta corta, positiva y negativa. ¿De acuerdo? Aquí nos va a apoyar también cómo responder de la manera correcta. Aquí ya habíamos visto, there is es para referirnos a una sola cosa o persona. There are para referirnos a más de dos personas o más de dos cosas. Utilizamos el negativo para decir que no hay, ¿de acuerdo? Y pues las respuestas cortas ya las habíamos visto. Vamos a responder aquí. It says complete. There are two shirts on the bed. Now, there is a toy store next to the restaurant. Aquí nos dicen las cantidades. Cuando nos viene un número, obviamente estamos hablando de que es algo cuantitativo y cuando no, estamos hablando que es solo uno. Cuando nos viene el número, nos dice la cantidad y aquí solo nos dice que estamos hablando de uno. Por consecuencia, es there is. Five, book on the desk. There are, very good. There is a mouse in the library, very good. Let's change this into questions. Vamos a realizar preguntas de la misma manera. Nos viene la cantidades. Are there three cars? What you can tell me? And then you answer. Después pones aquí tu respuesta correcta. ¿De acuerdo? Cuenta. One, two, three, four. Yes or no? Next one.
Are there two dolls?
Cuenta y responde.
Is there a scooter?
Answer. Tú vas a ponerme aquí la respuesta. For
three.
Are there three drums? Your answer, tu respuesta.
And are there two balls?
Y tú vas a colocar las respuestas para que de esta manera puedas practicar tus respuestas cortas. Aquí no decir si es afirmativo o negativo. Esto es lo que vas a responder aquí abajo dependiendo si estamos preguntando con are o con is. Are or is, ¿ok? Continue. Let's pay attention to this song.
There are pencils in the classroom, yes there are. There's a cupboard on the pencils, yes there is. There's a ruler on the cupboard, there's a bookcase on the ruler. There's a teacher on the bookcase, yes there is. There's a teacher on the bookcase, yes there is. There are pencils in the classroom, yes there are. There's a cupboard on the pencils, yes there is. There's a ruler on the cupboard, there's a bookcase on the ruler. There's a teacher on the bookcase, yes there is. There's a teacher on the bookcase, yes there is. There are pencils in the classroom, yes there are. There's a cupboard on the pencils, yes there is. There's a ruler on the cupboard, there's a bookcase on the ruler, there's a teacher on the bookcase, yes there is. There's a teacher on the bookcase, yes there is. There are pencils in the classroom, yes there are. There's a cupboard on the pencils, yes there is. There's a ruler on the cupboard, there's a bookcase on the ruler, there's a teacher on the bookcase, yes there is.
That's really funny, right? Thanks. Any question? You can find me on WhatsApp. Remember, stay at home, keep distance between people, and wash your hands. See you in the next class. Goodbye, butterfly. See you later, alligator. See you soon, raccoon.